YouTube, Movie Prodigy 25 here with my top 5 movies of 2012. I am 5 days late, but I don't care. I've been relatively lazy when it came to movie reviews, which is awful because I shouldn't be doing that. One second. I'm back. So, rounding off. Alright, let's start right now, okay? So, running off my list at number 5 for my top movies of 2012, Ted. Stars Mark Wahlberg and Seth MacFarlane and Mila Kunis. One of the funniest movies I've seen that I saw last year. I have the privilege to see it in theaters. Not a movie for kids, but, you know, 17-year-older is a good thing. You know, my parents had no problem with me seeing it, but anyway. Number 5 was Ted. Running off at number 4 was 21 Jump Street, starring Channing Tatum and Jonah Hill. A spinoff, well, a movie compared to the TV show 21 Jump Street. Another one of those movies that's not probably for kids. You know, 17 or older, whatever you prefer, whatever your parents prefer, but if they don't care, then, you know, see it at any age. Anyway, running off at number 21 Jump Street. Running off at number 3 would be Hotel Transylvania. This movie stars Kevin James, CeeLo Green, Andy Samberg, Selena Gomez, Steve Buscemi, and Adam Sandler. About Dracula, who wants to make a house, makes this place to where monsters can come to be away from humans, and turns out a human shows up, and it turns out to be a really good movie. You wouldn't expect it because of those Adam Sandler movies that have been coming out recently, but I personally loved it. So rounding off at number 3 was Hotel Transylvania. Rounding off at number 2 would be The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey. And if you look right over there, there's my Hobbit poster. I was able to see this movie in theaters as well. I saw it like last month, and I loved it. Absolutely loved it. It's great. I was one of those people that didn't like the Lord of the Rings movies. But after I saw this movie, and I went back and I watched the Lord of the Rings series all over again, I look at it at an all-new perspective, and I think it's great. If you guys don't know, it's about a hobbit named Bilbo who has to go on an unexpected adventure. And it gets him in a whole bunch of predicament, and it's great. I loved it very much, considering the fact that I didn't like Lord of the Rings at first. I was iffy going into it, but it's great. So, rounding off my list at number 2 was The Hobbit. Now, rounding off at number 1, number 1 and 2 can be flipped up a lot. It can either be, 2 can either be 1 or 1 can be 2. But because I didn't get to see all the movies of 2012, I've got to go with what I basically saw. And believe it or not, I did not see The Dark Knight Rises. So this is not The Dark Knight Rises, which is unfortunate because it probably would have been 1, 2, or maybe even 3. I don't know. But rounding off my number 1 spot for movie reviews of 2012 was The Avengers. I've got an Avengers poster right there. And if you look, I've got one right there. Now, the Avengers movie stars Chris Hemsworth as Thor, Chris Evans as Captain America, Scarlett Johansson as the Black Widow, Samuel L. Jackson as S.H.I.E.L.D., Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man, Jeremy Renner as Hawkeye, and Mark Ruffalo as the Hulk. This is another movie I had the privilege of seeing in theaters. I saw it with One Wheel 14, and I saw it with my other friend Jeremy Skinner. I'm not a huge comic book geek, but I knew who these people were before I went and saw it, you know, because of the other movies. But I had no idea whatsoever who Thor was until I heard about the Thor movie that came out. There's several really good things about this movie. One being the acting, one being the action that it gives off. Three, the transformations that Hulk goes through. There's one in particular scene where the Hulk just, you know, he's walking and all of a sudden he turns around and you can see him grow and his shirt rips off and he stops that flying thing from trampling over the crew, and it's just, it's mind-blowing. You know, I actually had a horrible seat in the movie theater. I was right in front of a guardrail, so I didn't get to see the 3D effects as much as other people. But yes, I mean, it was so good, I bought it. So, I mean, when I was done at the movie theater, I went home, well, the next morning, because it was a hangout night with my friends and I. But as soon as I had free time, I went and I pre-ordered my copy, and I got it, you know, when it came out, and I was itching the whole time to get it. I was like, come on, this is not coming fast enough, but one of my favorite movies of all time. Anyway, guys, that's my movie review for top five movies of 2012. I got another video to post right before this one, because I'm going to do like five videos just today, because I've been so behind. Before this one, I'm going to post up the Arnold Palmer Chug Part 4 with One Wheel 14 and I. So watch out for these two videos coming out, and the ones that are to come out ahead of time. So, like One Wheel and I have said before, like this video, subscribe, wherever it's at. I think it's over here, or down below. It might even be up top, I can't remember. But anyway, subscribe, like this video, leave a comment below telling me how you like it, and put it in the comments below what your top five favorite movies 2012 were, or just make a video response. It's your call. Your video list. You can do whatever you want. It's a free world. It's under one of the amendments. Anyway. So you guys, enjoy your 2013. See you guys later.